I'm sure you all agree to that. So I would like to open this round to some question answers. Like if questions, if you all have to address them, you're most welcome to ask them questions right now. Okay, we have one question. The gentleman.
Yeah. Hi, this is Zuhair from media over here. Soha and Chitrangda, both of you, looking great, absolutely. Since both of you are Bollywood celebrity and a public figure as well, so whenever the kind of aura and the stardom is attached to your persona, is that people follow you like anything, whatever you say, whatever you speak, that becomes the news. So when it comes to endorsing a product, how cautious are you about the credibility of the product, and what's your criteria of endorsing any product or whatever?
Okay, I think it's very important. As you said, nowadays especially, actors have become role models and people do follow you. I still am of the belief, though, that everyone should make their own decisions. And when people say you're a youth icon, I say yes, but to an extent. I don't want people to blindly follow me. You must read the leaflet and make your own decisions always and take responsibility. Having said that, when it comes to the products that I endorse, I absolutely have to look into the credibility of the company, look at the product, use the product myself. So that's something that, you know, the both of us have done. So that when we tell you that it has these wonderful properties and it does enhance the quality of your hair, we can say it with 100% credibility.
Yeah, exactly the same thing pretty much. But I just think that, you know, it's... if there's something that you believe in and it already has a certain amount of credibility, it's easier to endorse something like that. Instead of, you know, because I think somewhere or the other you can tell when you're selling a lie. But I can tell you one thing, that today, here, standing here, the kind of products that this company's come out with earlier, I think you definitely can't question, if that's what you're asking, the credibility of this, you know, company or this product today. So we completely endorse it because I think it's really good and I've used it myself. So, yeah.
Okay, there's a question. This gentleman in front, you have a question?
Jakir Sisodia from Makrana Magazine.
We can't hear you, sir. If you could.
Jakir Sisodia from Makrana Magazine. Leon Moroccan Silk Serum, jo itna late India mein launch kiya, iska reason kya?
Please repeat that, sir.
I think that the company has to answer this, I guess.
Yeah, I think one thing is better late than never. So it's good that it's here. I think that also, you know, I think it's taken a lot of time to discover. I mean, we've only just, you know, the argan fruit, the process of extracting it, then bringing it from Morocco to India. Now this is available in different parts of the world. So I'm just happy that it's here.
And don't forget the 20 hours that goes into it.
Exactly. It's not an easy process.
Yeah, good afternoon to all. This is Raj from media.
Hello.
I'd like to ask Soha and Chitra, what is the USP of this Leave-On product?
For me, I would say the USP is the detangling element, because that's what the serum really does. That's why when you apply it, when your hair is at its weakest, just after you wash it and it's a little wet and it has that tendency to get entangled, my hair always does. And when I comb it, It's a very difficult process for me, because as Chitrangada said, you actually count how much of your hair breaks. So if you apply this product, then it really helps to disentangle your hair and therefore protect it and save it.
What about you?
And yeah, no, it's pretty much the same thing. But it's just that for me, what worked when I used it was that it doesn't make your hair limp. Like, wo soft ho jata hai, lekin sometimes what happens, the hair becomes very limp. Aap usko condition, aap usko style nahi kar sakte hai. It doesn't hold its body. But this product is so light on the hair and it makes it soft that even after that you can make your, like, you can curl your hair, you can do things, and the hair doesn't fall flat. So for me, or for a stylist, I think that's a really important thing. So okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. The gentleman in front.
Hi. This is Sohail from Glam Sham. My question is to both of you all. Nowadays we see in our artists go to an extent, like, where if there's a certain kind of a role to getting into the character, they go bald also, in fact. We're talking about hair. So in case if a certain role which comes to you where you have to go bald, in fact, so would you be accepting that role? Are you aware?
It really depends on how amazing the thing is. It has to somewhere affect you enough. It has to excite you enough to want to do that. So, yeah, I think I would. I would, but, you know, it just depends on the role.
Yeah, I think it depends on who the director is. And it depends. You know, now you can computers, you can see what you look like bald. So I want to see what I look like bald. I think...
I've cut my hair really short for a film. There's a film called In Car that I did, and they wanted me to play a corporate woman. So at that time, I remember I had very long hair, and Sudhir Mishra, who was directing, said that, no, it doesn't matter. I need you to look like one of those corporate women who have very short hair. So my hair went down that short. Kanta cut my hair. She was the one. I remember her asking me like 2-3 times, are you sure? Are you sure you want to cut your hair? And
But you carried that look really well, I must say.
Thank
you. Compliments you.
Sometimes you do that. I mean, yeah.
But there are lots of products in the market. If you go to see, there are lots of imported serum or other products available. So how do you go about? Do you really personally try to see the thing, or your consultant, your hairstylist, they consult you and then you go along with that particular product?
I think it's very important to consult an expert. So I would certainly, somebody that I've worked with, somebody who I trust, I would ask them first if a new product was launched in the market. Then I would ask, for example, Kanta, and say, have you used this? And, you know, is it a good product? And I would definitely, and then of course you have to try it because everyone's hair is different. Your skin is different. So you have to see what works for you as well.
Yeah, I think it's very, like you said, I think we probably check out a lot more because we are using so many products, so much of heat treatment on the hair, that we need to be a little more careful. It's not once a week, not once a month. It is something that's happening every day. So,
I just wanted to add that, you know, this,
you need to.
I have used many, many products, but this is, it's like a simple solution, you know. You don't have to think, you know, oh, how much does it cost? It's like very easy. It's like, you can't go wrong with it.
You can carry it in your bag as well, right?
It's almost like a staple, you know. It's like